Hello friends, welcome to the Tetrahedron chemistry classes. So in this lecture we will see the various types of the bands that can be present in the molecule. That means the nomenclature of the bands, right? So here you can see in this slide I have written two bands here. First is the R band and second one is the K band, right? If you see this R band. So R basically it's German is originated. This R is originated from the German term, and the meaning of that German term is radical arctic, right? So as the name suggests, you see there would be the transition between, you see, from non-bonding orbital to the pi antibonding orbital, right? So generally this occurs due to the simple chromophoric groups, fine, and it is very common in case of your carbonyl compounds and the nitro compounds. But the problem with this R band is that they are having very low molar absorptivity coefficient. That means its epsilon value would be less than your say 1000, so it is not actually allowed transitions, fine, but we can observe it somehow, fine. Now moving to the next one, which I have mentioned here as the K band, right? This K bands, it's the most common and the most important band out of four, which is known as the conjugate bond. And this conjugates directly means what? Conjugation, you know, a double bond, single bond, and then a double bond. So presence of single and double bond, just I have shown here, this is the conjugation, right? So whenever the bands occurs from due to this conjugation, you know, these are the pi electrons. So what kind of transition can occur? Obviously, the transition would be pi bonding to pi antibonding, right? Why these are particularly important K bands, right? Conjugate or conjugation bands. Because their molar absorptivity coefficient epsilon is quite high. That means they are pretty much allowed. Now in this slide you can see I have written yet another two bond after your say R band and K band. Now it is B band and it is the E band, right? B stands for the benzenoid. That means benzene like system. Whenever you have the benzene like system, then you will have your benzenoid bands, right? And then E is your ethylenic bond. E stands for the ethylenic. That means ethylene unit, double bond, simple double bond is there. So whenever you are going to say, if you have this benzene kind of system, right? So what kind of band you can observe? You can observe B band as well as E band. Both kind you can consider, fine. So this B and E bands, as I have mentioned, they are the characteristic property of the aromatic compounds, whether you are say this type of aromatic compound like benzene, or say the heteroaromatic like your thiophene, pyrrol, furan, pyridine, and various others, fine. So again, transition, you know, B and E, because benzenoid and ethylenic double bonds are there, so this transition is actually again a type of pi bonding to pi antibonding transitions, right? But their lambda max value as well as their epsilon max value quite different from your simple alkene system or your carbonyl system, where you were observing that pi bonding to pi antibonding transitions, fine. So if you have this benzene like system, it is somewhere around ranges 180 nanometer to 200 nanometer. So you have to take little care about the oxygen absorption here, because it is say far ultraviolet region, fine. So no problem with this epsilon value. Somewhere around from 2000 to 14,000, right, epsilon max value. Now as far as your benzenoid, that is B bands, are concerned, say if you have the multiple fine structures, fine, you in this way, what I have written, first I'll read this line. The B band occurs in the region from 250 to 255 nanometer. Okay, this no problem with that. This is near ultraviolet region, and we chemists are generally interested in this region. And it will give you a broad band containing multiple fine structures. Here you can see. So symmetry forbidden transition, which has infinite but low probability due to the forbidden transitions. Fine. So these are the general terminologies. Nobody is going to ask you like that, this is the band, what is the name of this band, B band, E band. It's nobody will ask you this thing, but you should know the terminology involved in it. Here you can see I have written what? This is ethylenic bond having very high molar absorption coefficient here. Fine. So this is your conjugate band, right? This is conjugate band again. So this will have again very high this value. Then you can see the B bond, which for which I am talking about. So what it is giving actually here, it is actually multiply fine structure it is giving. Clear? So this is how you can see all these things. They are particularly important in, say, in your IR spectroscopy, not here actually. So guys, this is all about your the naming of the bands that occur in the ultraviolet spectroscopy. So if you are new here and you haven't subscribed the Tetrahedron chemistry classes, please watch, like, and do share with your friends, and subscribe the Tetrahedron chemistry classes. Don't forget to press the bell icon for the latest notification. Thank you. Thanks for watching.